Select the zoom tool. Then go to the level in the control bar, set it to 1600. That's a maximum. Also, display quality. Make certain you get a nice sharp display quality. You don't want the smoothing, so don't have that on. If you've got smoothing, it'll be blurry. Then go to the brush tool. Then go to graphic section, that's in the top left, graphic, and then go for square. Go to the size panel or the control bar and set it to 1. You just want 1 pixel. Go to the color set libraries and select yellow or green, etc. And you can see 1 pixel, that's it. Change the color and click again. Now it might put it below, I don't want that below. Just click it, make sure it's all in one line. Sometimes what happens when you change the colour and you click it, you will end up with 2 colours. But make certain the colour you want is in that top line, along that single row. And you can select all kinds of colours, 15, 30 colours, up to you. It does seem slightly odd because I'm going to capture this gradient, these colours, to create a gradient. But if you go for an image or go for a very complex, colourful design, you will literally end up with thousands of stops, but this approach, you will end up with a smaller number. Go for a rectangular section and make sure you select, just made a mistake, but I want to select that entire row. They're all selected now. So yellow, blues, etc., all selected. Go to the right side of the gradients panel and capture gradient. Click that and then give it a name. I'm going with gradient 03 and click OK. And now that is saved and you can see the icon has also been saved. Now I'm going to go to another document. Now by accident, I've got the selection there, so I've selected it. Doesn't matter, I'm just going to apply the gradient now, select the gradient tool and apply that gradient I've just created with those colors just to that. If I go back to the other one, commit it again, you can see the colors there. Back to that document and you can see that gradient. Of course you can tweak the gradient and change the gradient, but also you've got the gradient icon there. That's a key thing as well. Sometimes when you use the capture, you will end up not having anything there. But you can also set it, set custom icon or capture icon. That's another option. You can see when you use capture icon, it captures it and puts it there, which is very useful. So select none. And then you can apply it again. Apply it again. And you can also edit it using that right side menu. And you can see the nodes. You haven't got thousands and thousands of nodes. And if you were using it normally without using this pixel approach, you would end up with lots of nodes and make it virtually impossible to edit. It's not really good to edit when you've got lots and lots. And you can select any of those and change them. Of course, you can add additional ones. You can move them, change the colours, etc. Click OK and then save that.